So yeah, I love desserts. I also love beer. So the mission was to find a couple of places that combine the two. First stop, Jerry's in Wicker Park, where they serve a beer float. I'm interested. Very interested.
What makes your beer float one of the best?
A good beer float needs a good, sturdy, full-bodied beer.
Yeah.
We've got them.
And let's not forget the ice cream. Jerry's actually uses custard from Scooters.
Yeah, we thought it was spectacular stuff. Local, easy to get, and kind of unique.
This is good, but I really want dessert.
Each float has a vanilla custard base, and you get to pick the beer. Mark ordered us one with Père Jacques from one of Chicago's best breweries, Goose Island. The other float was a little more bold, vanilla custard paired with a smoked stout.
I don't know if I'd go with a smoked stout with ice cream. It's not terrible.
Could this be the first thing I haven't liked on the show?
I think in order to really try a float the right way, whether it's root beer or beer, you've got to have some ice cream with it, right? And that changed my mind entirely. And it's delicious.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I love it. I really love it.
And it kept getting better. I gave the Père Jacques a try.
Ding, ding, ding.
It's a fun idea.
It is.
We're not saying it's high cuisine.
It's not only fun just to think about, but it's really fun to eat.
And we're not done yet with the boozy dessert fun. We couldn't do a segment on alcohol-infused desserts without channeling our inner Irish. Mrs. Murphy & Sons executive chef Jeannie Carlson is going to fatten us up with three of her faves. First up...
So I'm going to make a black and tan sundae. I have a chocolate brownie. I'm going to add a scoop of chocolate Guinness ice cream.
Yep, chocolate Guinness ice cream. Love it. Jeannie makes this thing tan with a little Smittix caramel sauce, nuts, and a cherry. God help me.
That's phenomenal.
Can't eat yet. Two desserts left.
If you're doing an Irish dessert, you gotta have Bailey's in at least one of them, right? Because Bailey's is the dessert liqueur, so let's mix it with some custard, right?
Absolutely.
You're a genius.
thank you.
Jeannie really is amazing. She makes everything from scratch, including the souffle laced with caramelized soda bread crumbs. Ugh.
A little bit of strawberry sauce.
Strawberry, of course.
I'm gonna put a little bit of mango passion fruit sauce.
You cannot go wrong with mango when it comes to dessert. Does it taste just like Bailey's, but?
I think it tastes like Bailey's.
It better. And you actually have time to make your own ice cream.
I love ice cream, so there's always time to make ice cream.
Wow. Wanna come over?
Sure.
I have three kids.
Well,
you can leave the stout in, they'll be fine, I'll help them sleep.
And for her third and final trick, Jeannie serves up her Irish stout butterscotch ice cream, layered several times with a salted caramel sauce, garnishes it with a chocolate dipped pretzel and some Celtic sea salt. I'm so ready for these desserts.
Can we eat these?
Absolutely.
Okay, let's go. I'm about to do a jig. Seriously? Is that too big of a bite?
Couldn't be too big.
Nope. Next. Wow, that is, it's like an explosion of flavor in your mouth. I'm not getting out of here without eating all this. Thank you for changing my life.
You're very welcome.
Are you selling cupcakes?
Yeah!
There are a ton of cupcake shops in the city. This one, though, is on wheels. We'll go inside Chicago's first food truck.
Don't cry over spilled milk.
I spilled a ton of it while making ice cream at this spot.
Oh, God. See?
Good thing they have 40 other flavors on the menu. Our pick for Chicagoland's best ice cream in just a bit. All right, let's recap up to this point. The show, cool treats. What you've missed, Italian ice and a true neighborhood joint at Carm's.
Half lemon, half lime coming up. You want the lemon on the bottom or the lime on the bottom?
Sarah educated us on all things custard at Scooters in Lakeview.
You guys are in big trouble. You guys are so jealous right now. This is so good.
I got the tough assignment of experiencing a beer float at Jerry's in Wicker Park.
Cheers.
Yes, cheers.
And I learned what booze goes well with other desserts at Mrs. Murphy & Sons.
Bailey's or whiskey or stout, anything. It tastes great.
She's right. Now, though, it's time for Brittney to hit the streets as she introduces us to the coolest craze in the city.
So you've seen our picks for cool treats the whole show. Now we're gonna show you some treats that are really cool, and they're putting all their stock in Twitter and Facebook. I'm talking about Flirty Cupcakes. Flirty Cupcakes is Chicago's first mobile cupcake truck. Or should I say, van? Inspired by the ice cream trucks of her youth, Tiffany Kurtz tricked out this Econo line to pass out these petite pastries. Bakers start at 3 a.m. crafting these babies at Kitchen Chicago. Then they're packaged, loaded into the van, and transported to the masses based on feedback from Twitter and Facebook.
People communicate back and forth with us and try and suggest places. And if we get more than one person saying to come to a place, we try to hit it at least once a month if we can. We have people that keep coming back and back, and then they keep posting, and it's been amazing. Very good fans. Our fans are doing most of the work for us, really.
Including me.
Brittney Payton, headed to Madison and Wacker with Flirty Cupcakes. Come check us out if you're in the area. The cupcakes are unreal.
Can you post about happy hour too? Just remind people where we'll be.
Oh, we have 2,161 followers.
And counting. The number of Facebook fans and Twitter followers rise by the hour. The hustle and bustle of cupcake trafficking is no piece of cake.
Oh gosh.
Here you go, Cabby. Sorry for cutting you off.
Okay, is he letting me go? Oh my goodness, he is.
Awesome.
We love Chicago. Woo-hoo, thank you. 11:17, we'll make it.
Yep, go up one more.
Hi.
Are you selling cupcakes?
Yeah, we need a place to park.
Thanks for waiting, it'll be one sec. Thank you for coming back.
Oh no, thank you for coming here.
Perfect. Thank you.
So you show up at new locations, probably about an hour you stay at each location. Yep. And you guys have quite a few regulars too that come by now.
Yeah, we call them loyalists already, who spread the word for us, and they'll come back and they're like, oh, I've got to have the CBF again, or you know, I've got to have my PB&C. So they've already got their favorite.
A McDreamy, a coconut, and a no plain Jane.
PB&C, coconut, and McDreamy. So let us know what you think on Facebook. We'll get posts on Facebook that say, hey, we're holding a spot for you, hurry,
oh,
you know,
wow.
It's on this corner. Or we get
women standing in the streets. Like, no, this is for the cupcake truck. Keep going.
It really is. It's so funny. We posted photos yesterday of women doing that.
All my friends started being fans on Facebook, so I just decided to check it out, and I looked at the menu. I'm like, I have to do this. I actually came by yesterday and got a whole box of 12 and shared them, and now everybody's addicted.
Oh, wow.
I think what makes us the best is that we're doing this really with the customer in mind. At the end of the day, we do have really good cupcakes. It's all about the product. All right, thank you so much. Don't let anybody mug you.
Talk to me about this food truck kind of concept that's going on, because there's nothing really like that here in this city. You see it in New York and you see it out in LA, but you're really the first to kind of take this here to Chicago.
There's a lot of people that really want to start the business, and then there's also a lot of Chicagoans who really want it here. I probably get 25 emails a day from people asking me for advice and how to do it, and I'm trying to help all of them as well, because I think the more we can get on the street, the better it is for everyone.
This thing is absolutely amazing. It tastes unbelievable. I'm about to tweet all my friends right now and tell them they gotta get down here and check out this cupcake truck. And for all of you at home that want to learn more about Flirty Cupcakes, you can head to our website at chicagosbesttv.com.